This video is part of a series about programming. This episode will look at loops. So in this video we look at repetition in for loops and while loops, and this includes pseudocode examples and practice. Stay to the end because there's a bonus section on range. So repetition. Here we've got the 5 times table, so 1 times 5, 2 times 5, up to 10 times 5. You can see we can create print statements, any output goes from 5 to 50. What happens if we wanted to do that up to 100 times 5? That's a lot of code. Here we're printing each day of the week. When we get to the end of the week, we continue with the next week. So again, a lot of print statements. Well, we can use a loop. Here we print 7 days in a week and we just repeat it in a loop. So we go from the end to the beginning. Again, here we're going to repeat, and here we're going to use I as a variable, and that's going to go 1 to 10. We multiply that by 5 and you can see the same output in our first example. Now that means we can simply change the code, repeat I from 1 to 100 if we wanted to do up to 100 times by 5. So you can see the benefits of using a loop. Let's start with a for loop. So here's a for loop in Python. We've got for number in 2, 4, 6. We print the number and that prints 2, 4 and 6 on different lines. So we have some code such as this print statement. We have the word for. We have the space, the indentation before our code to show it's part of the for loop. Then we have this part of the for loop that shows what we're going to iterate, how many times we're going to go around, if you like, how many repetitions. And don't forget the colon. So that's our example that prints 2, 4 and 6. In another example, we've got 3 print statements. So we've got number plus number, multiply number by itself, number times 2. So here we've got 4, 4, 4, 8, 16, 8, 12, 36, 12. You can tell the 3 print statements are inside a loop because of that indentation. Let's look at some examples. Here we're going to loop from 1 to 10. Here we loop from 10 to 1. Here we're going to loop through 3 words, ant, cat and dog. Here we want to print numbers 1 to 10. We're going to use range. In this example, we've got 2 numbers in the brackets. 1 is where we start, and 11 is where we finish. But where we finish on 11, that's not included. So to print 1 to 10, we use 1 to 11 in brackets with range. It might seem a bit confusing, so we'll explain range at the end of the video. Here, we're going to print each character in a string. So we've got hello, then a space, and then coda. So you can see it prints the space as well as the letters. We can also put loops inside other loops. So here we've got the first loop is going to print 1, 2, and 3. And inside that we've got another loop that prints 1, 2, and 3. So we've got 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's a nested loop. We can also use the word break. So here we're going to print 1, 2, 3, 4. But if one of those numbers matches num, which equals 3, then we break out of the loop. So we print 1, 2, 3, but then we come out of the loop, so 4 doesn't print. So that's break. Now let's look at while loops. Here's the Python while loop. We start off with a number. We've got a while loop with like a condition, the same we had in if statements. We've got number is less than 5, print the number, and then we increase the number by 1. That prints numbers 1 to 4. So we've got the print statement, we've got the keyword while, we've got the indentation, we've got the condition that must be true or false. Now we must have that condition the variable used in L, in this case number, we must have a value to start off, and we must have a way to exit from the loop. So in our code we can see we can print 1 to 4 because number is less than 5. Once it equals 5, then it comes out of the loop. So remember, you must have a way of exiting. We can either use the break we saw before, the break keyword, or we can make the condition false. So for example, when a number equals or is greater than 7. So here, when a number reaches 8, it comes out of the loop. So this prints 2, 4 and 6. Number 2 plus 2 plus 2, and then out of the loop. Using break, we've got 2 plus 2 plus 2, and then if number is greater than 6, it breaks. So these are two methods of coming out of the while loop. Let's look at the pseudocode. Here's the for loop. We use the repeat word when we've got display inside the brackets. So that outputs the 5 times table, 5 to 50, 10 times we've multiplied I by 5. And the while loop, similar, we use repeat until. Let's look at some practice exercises. Write a loop that prints the letters in a word. Example, hello. So the output you can see here, we've got uppercase H, E, L, E, L, L, O, exclamation mark. 2. Write a loop that prints the numbers 0 to 8. Here's the expected output. Number 3. Write a while loop that prints numbers 1 to n, where n is a given number. So n equals 5, for example. We'll print 1 to 5. Write a loop that prints the cumulative sum of numbers. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But the output is going to be 1, then 1 plus 2, then 1 plus 2 plus 3, plus 4 plus 5. So 1, 3, 6, 10, 15 would be the output. Write a loop that counts from 5 to 1. And number 6, write a loop that prints the sum and average of 5 given numbers. So the average of these numbers is 3, and the total, the sum, when you add them up, is 15. Let's have a look at these solutions. Number 1, write a loop that prints the letters in a word. So we've got the word, the string, print each letter in that in a simple for loop. Number 2, again we've got a simple for loop. We've got numbers from 0 to 9 and we can print them. Number 3, we've got a while loop. So n equals 5 and we've got while number is less than n plus 1. So while it's less than 6, we're going to print the number. So that will print us our numbers 1 to 5. If we change n, this will still work. If we wanted to change n to 10, this will print numbers from 1 to 10. Number 4, we've got another for loop. We've got numbers 1 to 5. We can just add them up to print the sum. Because print sum is inside the for loop, is indented, that will print every time we go around the loop. So that's how we can print the sum, the cumulative sum of the numbers. Number 5, we've got another simple for loop, but the numbers start at 5 and go down to 1. Finally, the sum of numbers, we're going to write a loop and we're going to print the sum and the average. So we only need to do that after the loop. So we've got the numbers in a for loop, we add them together to make the sum. Then after the for loop, we can divide that by 5 to get the average, and then we just print out both the sum and the average. The bonus section on range. So here you can see we used range before to print numbers 1 to 10. But we used the word range and had 1 to 11 in brackets. Now we can use range with one number. So here we've got range 5. This starts at 0 and prints up to the number, but does not include the number in brackets. So going up to 5 will start at 0 and print up to 4. So it does print 5 numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if we've got two numbers inside range, the first number is where we start, the second one is the end. Again, we don't include it. So 1, 5 will print 1, 2, 3, 4. Finally, if there's three numbers inside range, the first number is the start, the second number is the end, not included, and the third number is step. So here we start at 1, we step 2 to 3, step 2 to 5, step 2 to 7, step 2 to 9, and then that's completed because the next number would be 11, but we finish the range at the end of number 10. Finally, here's using range code backwards. We start at 5, we go up to, but don't include 0, and our step is minus 1. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, great. If you learned something, enjoyed that video, please like. And if you haven't already, help our channel because we really like it when people subscribe. And it helps us keep going and keep making these videos. Thank you for watching.